Hey, welcome to another episode of Legion Elite Motorsports. I'm your host, Isaiah. And today, we are going to continue building the White Conquest, and we're going to show you how to properly install your Legion Elite coilover system. So let's dive in. Okay, so I took these off, painted them black to keep them from rusting because those are mild steel. We have the bumper buttoned up together down there. Have to add in the grill, all of the other good stuff. And also put together the thermostat housing. The fitting up top here is gonna look a little janky, but that's all I was able to get with the time squeeze. Everything else had to be ordered. And here we go. And yes, I plumbed in the vacuum lines as they were before everything was taken apart. I got everything down here tight. Got the silicone coupler here. No clamps because this is not pressurized, so that's not going anywhere. And that's a silicone hose. They have a tight grip. So, got the sensors down there. What else we got? Intercoolers at its proper height. Looking good. And also, gonna put together the rest of the grill and everything else, and that part will be complete. I'm going to adjust this pipe over just a little bit, and then I'm going to try to squeeze out some extra room once I put the battery tray down. But besides that, she's coming together. She's got engine oil. We have to do the tranny oil and the wastegate downpipe is here. Comes out right there. We go there, and we still have to bolt up the downpipe, but that is not a big deal. But yep, she's coming along good, and before you know it, we will have our first start. Still have to get a couple things and lines that come out here. Hopefully it doesn't touch the thermostat housing, but we will see. And what else? What else? What else? Yeah, pretty much about it. So I'm going to button up this cover, get this area sealed off and ready to go. And we're going to move on to the next thing. Okay, the whole front is together. Intercooler looking perfect. Now we're working on piping. So this blow off valve over here is something I'm giving the customer for free. He could swap it out whenever he wants. I had this laying around, wasn't gonna use it, so I figured, hey, why not? And plus it was the right size as far as piping, which is 2.5. And then I'm gonna finish the rest of this. I have to order the 90 degree 2.5 to 2 inches. That's what that is. Then over here, I'm going to add a 45, and then from here it'll be a 2.5 to 3 inch. So I'm gonna have to order that, and yeah, we should be good. But I definitely want to get the pipe to this area to see what we got. Okay, that is looking good. I tried to move this pipe over as much as possible without having to cut up the actual car. And yep, definitely not working. So I'm gonna let the owner know about the mishap, and we'll go ahead and relocate the battery to the rear. And in other news, I'm gonna cut this pipe, and then this will be ready to install also. So this will be a done deal shortly, and then we'll move on to the next thing. Okay, so we got this side done. That is awaiting a boot. Same with this side. And we are ready to drop in the radiator. So let me grab that. We're gonna pop it in. So this radiator definitely did not fit. I like that. So we're gonna have to go with another radiator. So that means that that has to be ordered. All right, first module plugged in is the knockbox. So that's in, plugged in good. Next, we're gonna plug in the ECU. And I am baffled. What in the world happened here? Okay. This is, and it's supposed to, a little stumped. I don't know what. Okay, so this one, and why do they have that going like that? And then where's the Yeah, I don't have the slightest idea. So that's gonna cause a wee bit of a problem. Just a little bit. All right, so I will definitely need to consult the owner to see what he wants to do with this stuff and take it from there. Okay, got the spark plug wires installed. I'm going to find and plug in the distributor wire and take that from there. Okay, so on the inside is looking like a car. The center console is completely put together, screws in on the side. We got telephone right there. I don't know who you're calling with that, but anyway, we got the armrest bolted in. The rest of these panels put in, so it's looking good. There's extra parts here, which is all gravy, but we're gonna go ahead and plug in the computer over here. I talked to the owner. He said that some other guy put in some components for either one, two, there's like four or five modules over there, and they're connected directly to the computer. So we're gonna let that ride and kind of cross our fingers and hope that everything operates the way we want it to when it's tune time. But we're gonna go ahead and plug in the computer and take it from there. So we will be back. Okay, we got plumber's crack right there. All right. Don't worry, I'll edit the butt crack out. But all right, so we are plugging in the computer. We have the panel for the bottom of the glove box, and then the panel that covers the computer.
What about all these random cables?
Yeah, I'm gonna kind of leave that up to the owner, because he said one of his modules is connected directly to the computer. I don't know if the computer's gonna like that, but we'll definitely find out. So yeah, good luck, I guess. But
well, hey,
yep.
We got a extinguisher just in case.
This is true. Safety first.
Let me keep it. Oh, it's empty.
Oh, that sucks. Okay.
So that means it caught on fire already.
I'm assuming so.
Look.
Otherwise, that wouldn't be. I hope that's not burned. But yeah. So that'll be fine. And then We are almost there. I think after this, next thing we have to do is bolt on the downpipe and the wastegate. And then that'll be it for now. We're actually waiting for parts for this one, so that means that we're gonna jump on the red one and smash out some stuff for that. The red one's still running, driving perfectly. I would say the red one needs new lifters because they're a little ticky, but I'll contact the owner and see if he wants to replace that on the red Quest. So yeah, so yeah, we're looking good. Everything's connected. I like the interior. It sucks when it gets worn out. It looks kind of pink, but this one's in really good shape. But yep, so we will keep you updated, and this car will be ready soon. Thank goodness. All right, so we are doing the downpipe right now. So give you an update on components. So what we're gonna do to the fuel rail is we're going to close each end and we're gonna put 6AN on the top of here and on the top of the other side. And we're gonna kind of do it like that so it's a little bit more user-friendly, easy to take off, easy to put on without rubbing anything in the firewall area. So we're gonna do that. This one's down and ready to go. I gotta put this piece on to cool the turbo, and then the other side of the turbo goes to the water pump, this guy right here. And that's pretty much all we can do until the parts come in, but she's looking good. What do you think, Alex?
Almost there.
I hear that. So once she's there, we'll be able to attempt to start it. I'm still a little fuzzy on the mega squirt procedures, but we'll overlook the book, talk to some people, and get it ready to crank up. All right, so day number 1000. All right, so we ran the power wire, so that's ran all the way to the back. We got a tuck on the inside so you wouldn't even be able to tell it's in there. We got the radiator, and we have the radiator fans, which these are modded to fit properly. But according to the ad of these fans, and these are the same fans I have on my silver car, not mounted yet. So we got this in. It clears everything with space. Perfect, perfect, perfect. We're gonna mount the actual radiator. We haven't done that part yet, but this is all test fitting. We got the plugs. 1 and 2. And we're gonna check out the back to see what that looks like. Mitsubishi Power, yeah, you know what I mean? That's how we do it. And then you'll kind of see what we're cooking with. So we have plenty of wire for the power, so the owner can move this battery wherever he wants. He could put it in the box, he can mount it to the strut bar, whatever he wants. He's able to do it. Then the ground wire goes to the bolt for the rear bumper. So that's simple and plain, nice tuck, and boom, she's ready to go. It's that simple, ground and power. So terminals will be here shortly, including the boots for 1 and 2. But yep, just wanted to give you guys an update. Everything is coming together like clockwork. It looks great. And we're going to continue to build. Okay, so after removal, which will be hard because this gets rusted really easy, you take out the bolt here, take a hammer with the bolt slightly threaded, knock it loose, and then pull it out from the backside. And then this part always gives the most trouble. You're gonna have to probably use some PB blaster on the inside of this and then start wedging a flathead in between here and here and start jiggling it up while pushing this down. And that should get you exactly what you want. So now we're on the other side, which is the assemble. And what you're gonna do is, this is Gen 1 suspension, is it comes pre-packaged all the way compressed for shipping purposes, so it's doesn't get damaged technically. And then you're going to unwind the base for your ride height. So we're going to unwind the base, and I made this sleeve actually a little bit smaller so it has a little wiggle room to adjust without getting stuck in there. So, as I was saying, you hold this and you loosen to go higher, and then you compress, you tighten to go lower. So we're gonna measure from here to here, or actually, I'm bring this down because this is our lock nut. And we're gonna measure from here to here and make it equal on both sides, and we'll be done. So I think this should give us a proper height. I'm gonna hand tighten that for now. I'm gonna lift this up. And that's probably better to use a jack to hold this up because this unit is not light. And then we're gonna pop in the two bolts here and we should be done. And now you can see the difference that this wheel is perfectly straight. And as for this wheel, you can see some negative camber there. So we're going to do the exact same thing on this wheel, get everything on and tight. Okay, so now for the front. I don't know what the deal is, whatever suspension's in here, but engine tranny's in, this should have came down, but it definitely did not. Three fingers, plenty of gap. So we're going to remedy that with Legion Elite's Best. All right, so we're not gonna disassemble too much of the front end due to the fact that it takes more time to put it together and all of that extra stuff. So what we're gonna do is we're going to disassemble, hand cut, and weld and reassemble. Keep it as simple as possible. So let's get to it. And basically what we're gonna do is we're gonna take off the caliper. Then there's two bolts at the bottom, which I'm gonna show you on the opposing side. So you could do it the easy way instead of the hard way, but one bolt here, one bolt on the other side, you remove the caliper. So you can take this, the wheel and everything off together as one piece. And then, excuse me, I had to get off the floor. Then you would be taking these off to bring down the suspension. But since this one has the camber plates, we're gonna use this piece, not this piece. So we're gonna take off the four screws and we should be good to go. So we're gonna get that done and we'll be back. All right, and also don't forget to loosen your sway bar. Drop that down a bit so you can pull the lower control arm down and pull that from under the car. So, yep, once that's done, you should be able to step on this piece, and the top piece or bottom piece can be taken loose at that time. Okay, so this one's taken apart, and luckily it was the insert. Factory, it's filled up to fluid to pretty much right about here, and it's really messy when you pull that thing out. So that's gonna make things easier and cleaner, as opposed to having to pour that out, and as you're cutting, you're smelling that fluid burning. Not fun. So we're gonna do the same thing to that one. We're gonna cut this shock down, and this is the important part, because you wanna cut it down 3 inches from the base. So this will be the base. You go up here about 3 inches, right about there, give or take. Of course, we're gonna measure it out properly, but 3 inches is a good rule of thumb. If you're trying to go super low, you can do 2.5. But even though the actual shock is height adjustable, you're cutting this to a certain length to see what your minimum is. And from your minimum, you can move up. So just wanted you guys to know that. And we're gonna chop these up and get the welding. Tube cut off from both, and what we're gonna do from here, because you know, no matter what you do, it's never gonna be quite even. We're gonna measure from here up to here again. We need a little bit more to make sure that we can even it out. So for instance, let's say this notch here is 3 inches and we got 3.25. So we're able to even it out up to the 3 inches. So we have that done on both of them. And now we're going to use our grinder to even it out and prep it for weld, and then we're gonna weld it up. Okay, and then once it's welded right there, then you can start putting in your shock body like that, and it works by the same geometry as the rear. So if you tighten the whole shock in there, that'll be low, but if you loosen it, that'll raise the car up. So we're gonna install, we're gonna see where the car sits, and then we're gonna equal everything out to make sure it's nice and pretty. And we're gonna do a nice 3D shot of the White Quest. Oh, there she goes. In a cooler. Subscribe, hit that bell icon for updated notifications, and I will see you next episode.